month to replace 800-779-4700.
Sorry, they're so stupid, are they? No Baron has ever owned a LeBaron. Or the Ford LTD. LTD. Limited. It's limited edition. What, are they make 50 million of those? Yes, it's limited to the number we can sell. Or when they try and mangle a positive word into a car. You know how they'll do that? The Integra. Oh, Integrity? No, Integra. The Supra. Or the Impreza. Well, I hope it's not a Lemona. Or you'll be hearing from my lawyer.
So, George, you sure I can't show you any other cars?
I don't think so, Vic.
Not my homework.
89 Volvo, that's the car for me, so what
I
want.
I got the Baron convertible right here.
And I, not interested.
It's got a few more miles on it, but the previous owner was John Voight.
John Voight?
Okay, Tim, you're welcome.
Was that too Wantley?
Yes, it was. He wanted your address. You, my friend, are going to be invited to his night before Thanksgiving party. You know, he's got that great apartment on 77th Street, and they overlook where they inflate all those huge balloons, the Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade.
I have always had a big crush on Tim Ryan. Why can't he ask me out?
Oh, he's a dentist. You don't want to go out with a dentist.
Why?
He'll always be criticizing your brushing technique. It'll drive you crazy. Away from the gums. Did you get the ball down?
Nothing is certain to go with an 89 LeBaron.
A LeBaron?
I thought consumer said Volvo was the car.
What consumer? I'm the consumer.
Huh? It's like friend's choice.
That might be so. But it was good enough for Mr. John Voight.
John Voight? The actor?
That's right. He just happened to be the previous owner of the vehicle.
You bought a car because it belonged to John Voight?
No.
I think yes. You like the idea of telling people you're driving John Voight's car.
Maybe I do, so what?
I've never even seen him in a car. I mean, look at his movies, no cars.
Hey, Jerry, you know that shoe repair place at the end of the block? Well, if they don't get some business, they're gonna have to shut down and make way for one of those gourmet coffee or cookie stores.
I like coffee.
I like cookies.
Of course you do, and you know why? Because you're a bunch of yuppies.
It's your corporate takeover lifestyles that are driving out these mom-and-pop stores and destroying the fabric of this neighborhood.
Well, what's so great about a mom-and-pop store? Let me tell you something. If my mom-and-pop ran a store, I wouldn't shop there.
People combo. They've been in the neighborhood for 48 years. Now, come on, Jerry. You got to have a pair of shoes in need of a cobbler.
They're the kind of shoes that have to be cobbled.
Well, what about sneakers? You know, they'll clean them. They do complete detail.
Kramer, without you, we'd be out of business.
Well, you know, these sneakers, they belong to my neighbor, Jerry Seinfeld, the comedian.
So many sneakers.
Well, he's got a Peter Pan complex.
I'll leave from 34.
No rush. I'll phone.
What's the matter?
I keep getting these nosebleeds.
Oh, lie down and put your head back.
Oh, yeah. Your ceiling.
What?
You got wires sticking out every which way. That looks dangerous. You should call an electrician.
Bill, in the 48 years we've been here, I don't think we've ever called an electrician.
Yeah, well, you should.
This place could blow in your head.